Hello everyone, this is Rick with Cybermedics and we're here today to talk about the Yolink smart water detection and smart water sensors. So let's get started. In particular, I want to cover four items on configuration and things that you might run into as problems or difficulties in setting up the system. And then if you stick around at the end of the video, I will tell you the resolution to a problem I had with one of the sensors that I could not get to work. So let's dive right into the first part of this, which is the valve state. So if you notice right now, the valve state here, the valve is closed. And this is what they call a probe sensor. I call a probe sensor because it has a opening at the bottom for a water probe cable. And this cable has been previously put in water, so, and paired with both the alarm system and the valve itself. Now, if you'll notice, when it alarmed, it opened the water valve. And the reason it opened the water valve is because when it was paired originally, the valve state was open. And if you want this valve to actually close when you detect water, then you need to make sure that it's paired in the closed state. So let's go through the pairing procedure. So that was the valve state, just to show you how important that is. And so the pairing procedure is pretty simple. You just hold the buttons down until they blink green. Now they're both blink green, and this has been closed, so we'll open it up. And then we'll insert the probe that's wet into the valve. And if you notice now, it closed the water valve, okay? That's because I paired it with in a closed state. That's why I wanted to go over that configuration with you. So the valve state is very important as to how you pair them. Now, the other thing I wanted to show you is that when you're pairing these, it's a little bit difficult to see this button because you put your finger over it, right? It doesn't have a separate light. So if you always press this button first and then press this other button, okay, you'll know that whenever the state of this starts to blink, this one will also be blinking. It's just a little trick so that you don't have to worry about trying to see, you know, underneath your finger, is this light working or not. All right, the next thing we want to go over is the unpairing. Okay, so let's say you have a different valve you want to control and you previously paired a sensor with this valve. So what you would do is go through an unpairing procedure, and it's similar. So like I said, we'll push this button first and hold it down. Then we'll hold this button down. And when it starts blinking red, well, both start to blink red, we'll let them go. And they communicate with each other, and it cleared the memory out of here as to this being paired. And we'll demonstrate that because we'll open the valve. And it won't have cleared the memory with the siren. See, it's still working with the siren, but it no longer alarms and controls the water valve. So that's the unpairing procedure that you need to go through if you decide you want to move it from one controller to another controller. Okay, so the next thing I wanted to go through was talking about the, I call these contact sensors because they have contacts on the bottom and they have contacts on the top. So if water gets on the top or the bottom, then these things will alarm. Okay. And about, I guess, mid-December, I had four of these sensors that just stopped working. They no longer would alarm. And I'm going to demonstrate, this has already been paired with the valve controller and the alarm, and we're going to put this in the water here, and I'll show you that you can see that it activated in the application and then it says there's an alert, but it will not communicate with the valve and it will not communicate with the siren. And I have four of these that were all purchased at the same time that just all of a sudden stopped working. Reached out to Yolink. They think it's a unique situation. I hope it is. They've been great in supporting and reaching out. I lots of praise for their efforts. I am concerned that maybe their firmware update may have broken some sensors, so I would encourage anyone that has sensors out there to test them to make sure that they're working. And if you think about it, that is one of the things to be concerned about here, is if you install all of this and you don't periodically test it, and like this sensor that's not working any longer, you assume it's okay, and then someday you have a leak and it doesn't shut off your water, that's going to be an issue. And there's no way to independently certify through the app or anything that the sensors are communicating properly with the valve. I mean, and this was a situation where the sensor just died, right? It doesn't work anymore. No explanation, no alert on your phone, nothing. It's just not working. So this is the new contact sensor. I told you I would tell you the resolution. So I purchased a new contact sensor and set it up with the valve and the alarm. Works flawlessly. And it was purchased, I guess, about a week ago or so. And they all work great. So haven't been able to explain why four of the particular sensors just died. And I purchased new ones and everything works fine. So obviously it's not a problem with the controller and it's not a problem with the siren. These both are working perfectly and they work with, I guess I've got six of these probe sensors, and all the probe sensors work fine. The new contact sensors all work fine. The only thread in all this is that these old contact sensors that I purchased, none of them are working any longer. If you have any questions or comments, please post them below. I am putting a link to the description of the original problem with these contact sensors in the description. If you have any questions, we'll be happy to answer them. Have a great and wonderful rest of your automation day.